puzzle, which will determine the winner, Betty White and Lucy Ball. Take a look.
Your best friend.
All right, Betty, pass the plate.
I will play.
Okay.
Michelob.
Beer.
Yeah. Okay, Dick. I'll remind you, Dick, it's for the game. What is that puzzle?
Milwaukee.
Yeah, well, is it Milwaukee? It is not Milwaukee.
Could have been Milwaukee.
Here we go. And then Betty and Lucille. Betty, pass the plate.
Enjoyment.
Fun.
Yeah, that's it. Dick, beer and fun.
A bar.
Well, is it a bar for the game? No, it is not. All right, Betty, we'll see you. Betty, that's
okay,
a play.
Okay, Berlin.
Berlin,
Berlin.
Germany.
Yeah. Yeah, right. Yeah. All right.
Beer, fun, Germany. Is it Munich?
Well, if it is, you've won the game. Is it Munich? Did you see Lucy over here shaking her head? No, you think you know, don't you? You may. I think you do. Betty, what do you think? Pass or play?
I'll play.
I'm so glad.
reaping.
Harvest.
Yes, that is it. Beer, fun, Germany, harvest. This is for the game, Dick.
Oktoberfest.
Ah, if you're right, you win the game. Is it Oktoberfest?
Yeah.
And there's a celebration.
I didn't know what to call it.
You're right, but it's in Munich.
I did not know what to call it.
But you knew what it was. You knew the event.
I knew the festival.
And they can't even spell it. Isn't that ridiculous?
Yes. Oktoberfest wins the game. $300 for Dick and Betty. And that, of course, will be divided between their charities. And we're going to go now over to Alphabetics. You'll excuse us, please.
Yes, have fun.
All right, let's go over and see if we can add another $5,000. Very good. You're going to give to you. You're going to give, you're going to receive. Yes. That's right. All right, you are going to give and you are going to receive.
Receive.
All right, now you got 300 bucks for your charities, and here's a chance to add to that $5,000. It'll be divided between your charities. We have 10 passwords for you, beginning with the letter A, going alphabetically to the letter J. Get all 10 in 60 seconds, and you get the $5,000. Okay. Betty, no one knows better than you how to play this. Take a look at that first word coming up now. It begins with A, and here is the word. Think of your clues. Okay, now, good luck to both. You have 60 seconds, and go.
Lincoln.
Abraham.
B.
Bass.
Ball.
Voice.
Basso. Baritone.
C.
C.
Islands. Caribbean.
D.
Republican.
Democrat.
E.
Jewelry.
Emerald.
Head. Lobe.
Earlobe. Ear.
Jewelry.
Earring.
F.
Vixen.
Animal. Fox.
Yes.
G.
Gander.
Goose. H.
Yiddish.
Hebrew.
I.
Amazing. That's
incredible.
J.
Mason. Container.
Jar.
Hey! Wow!
I never said that.
Oh, that's right. You've always given her.
Oh.
Woo! Oh, yes. Very interesting point. The first time he's received, and it's tough, folks.
One.
Well done. Now,
my respect for those contestants just went way up.
Oh, you betcha. For each of your charities, for each of them, $2,650. We'll be right back. Well done. You had 8 seconds left.
Oh, except when you're a winner, actually, you don't have to have that. But this way you do. I do. Here we go. $200 puzzle, that's what it's called. The winner of that one gets to play for the cash word, which is worth $1,000. Perhaps you will experience the magic toaster today, Howard.
I can hardly wait.
Yes, you will. You will enjoy it no end. Here we go, gang. Marcy and Jack giving the clues. Here comes the first word of the $200 puzzle. And Marcy, if you'll begin.
Clothes.
Closet.
Okay, Jack?
Frame.
Frame. Hanger.
All right, Marcy?
Holder. Rack.
Yes, whoa! Very good. Okay. Very good. Rack, Betty, what could that be?
So obvious. Oh. I don't know.
Oh, I don't either. Only one thing comes to mind. Couldn't be that. Next word, please. Oh, actually, two things come to mind. The home.
I had two thoughts in a row there.
My God.
Well, okay, Marcy, what do you think?
Animal. Polar bear.
No. Jack.
Bird. Hummingbird.
What did he say?
He said a hummingbird. Perfect. Yeah, absolutely. Wrong, but very good. Marcy?
Suit. Penguin.
Yeah! It finally dawned on me you were doing cold, weren't you? Well, I didn't know that.
Not a great actress.
I didn't know you were doing cold. I thought you were doing a very nervous penguin. We have Rack and Penguin.
Rack and Penguin. Is it paperback book?
Is it a paperback book? Oh! You need soft cover books, I don't believe that.
I don't either.
There's
somebody else playing this game.
I can't believe that. I can't believe that.
Just when you said that.
I am furious. How did you do that?
I'm not furious, Bert.
Don't be upset,
Howard. I
want
to thank
Howard.
You, but I have to go home.
No. I don't want you to worry about a thing. You're going to be fine. She does that sometimes. We don't know how, but it does happen. All right, Marcy has $200. Jack has $100. And it looks like you're going to get the magic toaster this round. Here you go. All right, take a look, Betty. We'll show the folks at home what the cash word is. It's worth $1,000, and you have 3 chances to communicate it to Marcy. You know that. Off we go. We're ready for clue number 1.
Ointment.
Cream.
Clue number 2.
Sloan's
pills.
Third clue.
Reliever.
Well, antiseptic.
Oh, those are perfect clues. Perfect clues. Ointment is good. Sloan's. What is it, audience? Sloan's liniment. It was perfect. Okay, too bad. It has nothing to do with it. They still sell.
Is it in the market still?
Oh, sure. Sloan's liniment's still sold, isn't it, gang?
When you're playing with an old broad, yeah. It does make a difference.
Okay, next time the cash order for $2,000. Marcy has $200. Jack has $100. We'll change partners and break away and come right back. That was perfect. Ointment and Sloan's.
Desi. All right, Desi, the option is yours. You want to pass or play?
I'll pass.
Uh-oh. All right.
Plymouth Rock.
Nope. Desi?
People.
Pilgrims.
Yes. That's putting them together, Dick. All right. You guys need this to tie the score, Dick. It's Pilgrims. What's the puzzle?
Thanksgiving.
Is it Thanksgiving? Oh, good try. Good try. Desi. Lucy. All right, you got it? Okay, Desi, pass or play?
Pass.
Fly. Turkey.
No. Desi.
But they had turkey in the Pilgrim. Don't laugh.
That's right.
You won't learn anything.
No reflection upon the show, it's just Desi.
Birds.
Wing.
Yeah. Yes, boy.
Psychic.
All right, Dick, it's for you. Pilgrims and wings, and what's the puzzle?
I'll say turkey.
Well, if you're right, you've tied the score. Is it turkey?
Yeah!
Yeah. November, holiday, Thanksgiving, and it is a bird, that's for sure. Well, we have $100 apiece. That means this is a $200 puzzle. This will determine the winner. Betty, pass or play?
I will play.
All right.
Cruise.
Float.
No. Dick?
Europe?
Voyage?
No. Betty, final clue on your side.
Sightsee.
I know.
No. Dick, final clue now.
Hawaii.
Ocean liner?
No, they were looking for travel, just travel. The generic travel. Yeah. So it goes on the board. No one gets a chance at it. Dick and Betty look at this one. Betty, pass the play.
Okay, I'm going to pass.
All right, Richard.
Kissinger.
Henry?
No, Betty. No, it's all right.
Ambassador.
State.
No. Dick, final clue on your side.
Core.
Peace.
No. Yeah. Betty, final clue on this particular password.
Arbitrator. I know.
Yeah.
Oh.
Lucy, what you were trying to think of was diplomat. Right. Diplomat goes on the board. Now you have travel and you have diplomat. Here's the next one. Dick and Betty, look at it. Oh, yes. Betty, pass or play?
I'll play. Alexander...
Great?
No. Dick.
Well, I don't know.
Secretary.
Oh.
Time, Betty.
State.
Haig?
Uh-huh, that's it.
Good.
I'm sorry.
All right, Lucy, it's for you. Travel, diplomat, Haig. It's tough, I'll tell you.
Let's
see what
These
this does. Here, Dick and Betty, look at this one. Betty, pass or play?
I'll play.
All right.
Caligari's.
Caligari's? Caligari's? I don't know what that means.
All right.
Caligari's.
Yeah, okay.
Cupboard.
Cupboard?
Final clue on your side, Betty.
Dishes.
Cupboard.
No.
Other Hubbard.
No, Dick. Final clue.
Caligari.
Kitchen.
I can hardly wait to look that up.
Utensils?
No. It was, I have to give it to you, those are the four clues.
Shelves?
No, cabinet.
Yeah. Cabinet.
Cabinet. Cabinet.
Cupboard.
Yeah.
It's
Caligari's cabinet.
The cabinet of Dr. Caligari's,
yes,
you know, is a
famous scary.
All right, Betty, pass or play?
I'll play.
We'll play fair.
Caligari. Don't be sulky, Lucy. Be sweet now. You're ruining your image. I didn't say be sickening. I just said be occupation.
Oh, occupation. Work.
No. Dick.
Work.
Job?
Yes, that's it.
Oh, that's it.
All right, Desi. Travel, diplomat, Haig, cabinet, and job. Desi, what is it?
Secretary of Defense.
Is it Secretary of Defense? It is not. Dick Martin, you get a crack at this. What is it, Dick?
Secretary of State.
I'm sorry.
Is it Secretary of State for the game?
Yeah, boy. I was just kidding.
Woo! So the guys win the game. They're going to have a chance at alphabetics after these words.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Welcome Back, Carter, Helene Lembeck. From Family Feud, Richard Dawson. And Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game, PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game, PM, Gene Rayburn.
Olson, how are you? My cup overfloweth. And so do some of yours, too, I see. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game PM. You're going to have a good time because they open the doors to the loony bin. And we are all gathered here together, including our two civilians, Gwen Tyler and John May. Now, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you before we begin. John, we'll begin with you. Anything you wish to contribute is okay with us.
Fine. Gene, how much time have I?
Oh, you got about 8 seconds.
Good. I'm a retired welfare administrator. I have 6 kids, ranging in age from 41 to 16. 3.5 grandchildren, ranging in age from 16 down to almost. I like fishing, I like gardening, and I think that the Los Angeles Dodgers are just beyond compare.
You're rooting for the hometown, eh?
Yes.
I like your spirit, John.
Well, thank you.
Good luck to you. Now let's find out about Gwen Tyler here.
I'm from Diamond Bar, California. I have a lovely husband and 2 beautiful daughters, Andrea, 6, and Jennifer, 1.
May I make just a slight correction, you see. If your husband were here, he would say, I have a lovely wife. But you can't say you have a lovely husband because that just makes it a little strange.
Handsome and wonderful.
Handsome and wonderful. Terrific. Okay. You have a handsome and wonderful husband. Yes.
And I'm a full-time homemaker.
And you're what?
Full-time homemaker.
A full-time homemaker.
Right.
Okay. Good luck to both of you. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have 3 opportunities to match as many of our celebrated, beautiful people as you possibly can.
Did you call me Jean?
Yes, I did. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and we'll go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Here we go. John, are you ready?
I'm ready.
A or B?
I'll take A.
A for John May.
A for John May.
Fred said.
Okay.
Fred said, I suspected my wife didn't love me anymore, but my worst fears were realized when I went to bed and found blank between us. I suspected my wife didn't love me anymore, but my worst fears were realized when I went to bed and found blank between us. Shall I go to the next window now and with my green stamps?
Do whatever you want, Mr. I'm off duty.
Oh, all right. All right. We're just about ready, John.
What was the guy's name?
It doesn't make any difference.
It was Fred.
Fred.
It does to Charles.
All right, John, here it is. Fred said, I suspected my wife didn't love me anymore, but my worst fears were realized when I went to bed and found blank between us.
A bundling board.
A bundling board. What a wonderful old-fashioned answer. Now, hold on just a minute. In the early colonial America, when a fellow was courting a girl and he went to visit her at her house, it was very cold in those log cabins, and so they wanted to hold hands and do other things. And so they would get into the bed under the feather mattress, but there was a piece of wood, like a 2x12, between them. That was called a bundling board.
Gene, my wife told me that. I didn't know anything about it myself.
What do you say to that? He says a bundling board.
Ah, bundling board. I say it was her mother.
Her mother. A live bundling board. What do you say?
Well, she had a lot of plans for leaving the country. Her fiancé.
Why don't you been found her fiancé between us? Well, what do you say to that?
I said my brother Arnold.
My brother Arnold. When I went to bed and found my brother Arnold between us, that would be very bad. Worst fears were realized when I went to bed and found a bundling board between us, according to John May.
No, I was a little bit more practical. I said her lover.
Her lover. Well, we're slowly going downhill here, Richard.
But we're all going together. That's
right. We'll have a good time. My wife didn't love me anymore, but my first worst fears were realized when I went to bed and found a bundling board between us.
No, Charles Nelson Reilly.
Aha! Very interesting. Yes. What do you say?
Is that who that was?
Yes.
I could have sworn it was Gene Rayburn.
Oh. Really?
You think I would know the difference?
Me and Charles, eh? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm going to give that panel just one more chance, Gene.
No. Two more.
Okay.
Two more. Paul John's okay. Betty White's goldfish hasn't been the same since Betty washed her blank in the goldfish bowl. Her goldfish hasn't been the same since she washed her blank in the goldfish bowl. Betty White's goldfish hasn't been the same since Betty washed her blank in the goldfish bowl.
Her cat?
Her cat. Does one wash a cat?
This lady? Betty does.
All right, what do you say?
I'd said it was her husband, Alan Nudden.
Must be a big bowl. What do you say?
I said her pussy cat.
Thank I you. See.
Thank
one
you.
For Glenn. All right, Chuck.
Chuck said her teeth.
Her teeth. Well, really. Betty White's goldfish hadn't been the same since Betty washed her blank. Go ahead.
Being the homemaker that she is, I said dishes.
Dishes, yes, she is a homebreaker.
Maker. What do you,
maker.
Maker. A maker, yeah. She's a maker.
Right.
What do you say?
The fish passed on, you know. Autopsy. Autopsy revealed.
The cat ate the fish.
Autopsy revealed overdose of pantyhose.
Oh! Well. Now, Miss Betty, tell us the truth. What happened in your household?
I can handle either the audience or my friends, but I cannot handle you both. There's no way. Now, what did our friend say? That the
cat.
Kitty cat.
She said, oh, cat, there it is.
Thank you!
Well, there we are, in a round, one score, it's 2-0. Now I got this message just for you.
Get ready to match the star. Avery Shriver. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Barbara Rose. From Family Feud, Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn!
Hello there, it's Gene Wilder. No. We welcome you and thank you for joining us, and we thank you for joining us. Aren't you a dandy-looking bunch? Charles! You're wearing a brown velvet jacket. What does that mean?
It means I have good taste.
Oh,
and you didn't buy it from
much.
The man I bought it from.
Yes.
You didn't buy it from him, did you?
No, I bought it mine.
Because he warned me about wearing blue.
Yes, of course. Would you welcome Gus Kuchler and Puff Contreras? We welcome the two of you.
Thank you.
Before we begin this competition, may we ask each of you to tell us a little bit about yourselves. Puff, we'll begin with you.
My name is Puff Contreras.
You're Puff Contreras.
But it's not because of my present condition.
What is your present condition?
Puffy.
Oh, you're puffy. Oh, yes. Oh, I see that now. It's hard to tell when you're sitting down.
I mean,
you are puffy.
A little bit. I've been married for 4.5 years. We have no children, but in about 3.5 weeks, we will.
3.5 weeks you will?
Yes.
Well, that's wonderful. We're very happy for you.
Thank you.
What is your real name, Puff?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth is your... You look like an Elizabeth. Doesn't she look like an Elizabeth?
I don't feel like an Elizabeth.
Yes, that's what you were just
like
saying.
Elizabeth,
she looks like Elizabeth. All right, mm-hmm. Good luck to you, Puff. Gus, where are you from and all that sort of stuff?
I'm from Escondido.
Escondido.
That is God's country.
It's a beautiful place.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
I've been down there about 7 years, have a lovely wife and a home manager. Not her, our miniature schnauzer.
Oh, runs the whole thing.
Right. I'm retired, but my wife is still working. She's in communications.
Aren't we all?
Right.
Right. Good luck to both of you here on Match Game PM. Each of you will have 3 opportunities to match as many of our celebrated stars as you possibly can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the 3rd round will be the winner, and we'll go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. So here we go. Okay, Pump, A or B?
B.
We're off and running. Hey, did you hear about Tough Tony?
No.
Well, to show everyone how tough he was, he went to the zoo and blanked a porcupine.
That's tough.
That is really tough.
You got that dress at a kimono sale.
Talk about dating yourself, a kimono sale.
Puff,
when was the
here
last
it is.
Time you heard the word kimono?
Tough Tony, to show everyone how tough he was, he went to the zoo and blanked a porcupine.
He bit him.
He bit a porcupine.
Yes.
Needle stuck in his teeth. Had a terrible time. Painful thing. Avery?
I thought it was tougher than that. I had him hugging.
He hugged a porcupine.
Yes.
That would get him full of needles and quills. What do you say?
No, no. He sat on him. He's been singing soprano ever since.
Okay, Chuck.
He pet a porcupine.
That's not tough enough.
All of those things would be painful and get him in trouble. Puff is looking for the answer, bit. Tough Tony went to the zoo and blanked a porcupine. She said he bit a porcupine.
Did you hear how they booed and hissed?
They booed and hissed Charles' answer.
No, her answer.
Oh, her answer. Yes, of course. Yes.
Good.
Well, I tell you, Barbara, they're a fickle bunch. They booed her answer and they cheered yours.
Amazing, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yes.
I said hugged.
He hugged a porcupine.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt him, except when he drinks water now, he has to wear a raincoat.
It's a sprinkler system, built in. Right. What do you say there?
Well, animal lover that I am, he made love to a porcupine.
Made love to a porcupine. Oh, dear. All right, Gus, you ready for yours?
Yes, sir.
Here it is. Betty White said...
What?
She said, my husband, Alan London, is not quite as funny as a barrel of monkeys, but he's just about as funny as a case of blank. Not quite as funny as a barrel of monkeys, but just about as funny as a case of blank. So here
well,
we go, Gus. Betty White said, my husband, Alan London, not quite as funny as a barrel of monkeys, but he is just about as funny as a case of...
Measles.
Measles is a very good answer. You did get the idea. We got the idea, and I hope you did, too.
Yes. Well, close. Case of hives.
Hives. All right.
No, I went for that. You said chicken. I stuck in with the animals and the bites. I said chicken pox.
Not quite as funny as a barrel of monkeys.
A case of chicken pox.
Oh, all right. That's good.
See?
Two
Does
acceptable
anybody
answers.
Get it?
Three
Is there
answers.
Anybody out there?
Yes.
Flu.
Flu. Three diseases so far.
Chicken pox.
Got a lot of diseases there. What do you say?
This is where Barbara gets to show how dumb she is.
What is that?
Case of beer.
Case of beer. Case of beer.
They are strange. They are.
You're Rich? Not just another pretty face. Measles.
Measles. There's one for death. Now, Betty White, we come to you for the moment of truth.
Thank you, Barbara, for the least obnoxious answer so far.
Yeah.
You realize this is my husband you're talking about?
Oh, we're just
You
funny.
Tell us, fat lady. Anyone realize that?
Yes, we all love him. It's your husband.
A case of the flu.
The flu. The flu. There we go. End of round 1, 1-1 to score. Round 2 coming up after this. Hurry right back.